page. It's your guy Ernest. Throughout this tutorial, I would like to take this opportunity to show you the process in creating a website with or without a coding language in a simple approach. So by the end of the tutorial, you should be able to create a site like this in a simple language. If you have a coding skills, then it's a plus for you. If you don't know it, I will show you how to go by it in a simple way. So don't worry. You go by the content management system. But before that, you should know the meaning of the content management and how it works, which will make things very easier for you to understand. By the end of the lesson, you will be able to create all these testimonial pages, upcoming events, recent posts, all these products and services and support. If they read more, then with the sliders you can increase it to 5. I will show you how to go by all those approach, which will make things very simple for you. But like I said, when you talk about content management system, it's a software which stores all your data such as text, photos, music, documents to make them available on the website. There are so many content management systems. You have the Drupal, Jumia, and WordPress. But I'll be using a database, MySQL 5. You're using a database, MySQL 5. Then the Apache server. But if you're using Windows, you can go on the internet and download WAMP or XAMPP. If you're using Linux, you can download LAMP. But XAMPP is a multi-platform system, so you can use that one also. Macintosh, you can use the MAMP. I've already downloaded them here and I've installed it. So when you're done installing the XAMPP, this is how it looks like. Click on the Apache server to start it. Then you start MySQL also. When you're done with it, you should go to your drive C. Go to your drive C. Yeah, yes, your drive C. So you see XAMPP here. When you're done with the installation, you see something XAMPP here, folder called XAMPP. You locate atdocs. Yes, atdocs. Let me open it bigger for you to see atdocs. Okay. Now you should create a folder here which will bear the name of your site, so that we extract the WordPress content into that folder. So let's go by that approach. We create a folder. So my site name will be Nextto. I'll double click on it to open it. Then here is the WordPress. So I'll copy it and paste it here, Control V. Now I want to extract the content into this folder, so I'll extract it here. Extract here, make things very easier. Like I told you, if you are watching this tutorial, don't give up. It doesn't matter whether you have a coding skills or without it. I'll show you the simple and easy approach to go by creating your WordPress website. Don't give up at all. But anyway, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you keep up updated of the various videos that I have on board. I'm showing everything. If you have any question, you can PM me with my email through my email or my WhatsApp contact, and I'll respond to you. Thank you very much. So we are still waiting for our things to be extracted in a nice way. When it's done, still waiting. waiting for it to be done, then we go by it. Okay, thank God everything is done successfully. So here is it. Okay, everything is extracted here. In order not to confuse yourself, it delete this one. So delete, everything is gone. Now extract the content that you have in this one. Press Ctrl plus A, Ctrl plus A, Ctrl plus A to select all, then Ctrl plus cut, Ctrl plus X. So it will cut everything. Click on back, the back arrow, then paste all the content here. Ctrl plus V, all the content will be pasted here successfully. Now delete this one so that it will not be confused with it. Delete it. Yeah, you're true. Now we should open our browser. You can choose to use any browser, but I'll be using Firefox. So you open our browser, since check to see whether you have your server, your XAMPP control, everything is working. Yeah, it's working. Yeah, so I open my Firefox, then type localhost. So localhost, because you are hosting everything on our own machine. We've not bought the domain yet, so we are hosting everything on our own machine. So localhost slash php my admin. Okay, so this thing will open. Click on new, and what we are about to create here should bear the name of what we have in our folder, so that there can be a link up of the installation of the WordPress. So we type the name. It was Nextto. Let me check to see, so that there wouldn't be any form of confusion. Yeah, it's Nextto. You can see here, it's Nextto. Okay, yeah, so I'll click on create. Okay, so now when this one is done, you open a new tab, then you click on, we type localhost. Make sure, don't forget to type localhost and everything that you did before your next step. So localhost, then I'll type my site name. My site name was Nextto. Now we are about to install our WordPress. This is what we show if we did the extraction very. So we click on let's go. Okay, now clear this one, the password, clear everything from here, the username, clear everything, and make it root. Okay, and then I click on submit. Okay, so you type your site title, then username admin. For me, I type admin, the password, clear everything, I type admin one. You can choose to use any password that you want. And then when you're done, you click confirm password, you type in your email, then you click install WordPress. So when everything is installed, you click on login. So you type admin, I use admin one. So everything is done. There's our dashboard. Everything is successfully installed. Thank you for staying with me. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. On our next tutorial, I'll show how to do the various editing. So with this one, you can visit your site to see how it looks. Yes, how it looks. But don't bother, I'll show you how to design everything to make it look nicer. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. With the next tutorial, I'll show you how to go by the various editing. Thank you for staying with me. Have a nice day.